It's a make or miss league. Yeah.
Make, miss.
Oh.
It's a make or miss league.
So make! Hezzy's Magic Kings. Crunch time in Sacramento. Watch the move by De'Aaron Fox.
Oh, both of them went.
Yeah. Right? I mean, Markel might still be.
Man, synchronized.
y'all gotta talk on that. We switching? We not switching? What are we doing?
We got the win, though.
Yeah, there you go. There you go. Our Miss Laziness, Sixers, Pacers. CJ McConnell gets the off-balance bucket.
Yeah, work hard.
Right? Then hustles back. Little steal and dish.
Oh, there you go.
Right up to Holiday for the jam.
Oh, and he just gives it all out. There you go.
Right? T.J. McConnell was mic'd.
Play hard in everybody.
For this game, it was amazing. I really encourage everyone to find it online.
He said, he told the ref, don't say anything incriminating. I'm wearing a wire.
On a wire. And then he presumed to say all kinds of things. He was fantastic. Mate, quickness. Pelicans Pistons, check out the step back by Lonzo Ball on Christian Wood.
Hey. Oh, ooh.
Pelicans are coming.
Ooh.
Watch out.
Zoe has had resurgence, right, in the last month. So they think a lot of that's been tied to his health.
They're getting better. I'm just saying right now, I know they're the 14th team in the West. I'm telling you right now, that big boy's on his way, and their second half of the season is going to be a lot better. Yeah.
So fun. All right, Miss Tack. Oh, yes. Back to Cavs Lakers. Tristan Thompson getting the dunk just before half. But watch what he does afterward.
Yeah. Let him
know. He stares down LeBron.
Let him know about it.
Kind of has no time for him. But then up in the third quarter, LeBron catches a lob. And look. That's more of Tristan. But now here's LeBron.
Oh. Yeah. That's unfortunate.
And he gives him a little bit of a.
You know what, man?
There.
What?
Do you have to be worried, Mac, when you're out there if you have a little premature stare down?
Nah.
Did you get it?
Not at all.
Yeah, man.
I actually welcome it. Because playing against a team like the Cavs, I need something to, motivate me. You know what I mean?
And hey, if you're Tristan Thompson, man, it can't get worse.
I need something to wake me up.
It can't get worse.
That should not be anyone's motto. Hey, it can't get worse.
Yeah.
I will say they were boys after the game. They were doing all their hands slapping and things, all that stuff. All right, make vision. Bulls Celtics, Marcus Smart taking Zach LaVine's cookies.
This is
that.
Right? Then nice. Dimes up Gordon Hayward.
Nice.
How important is Smart to the Celtics? Because he's,
in some way,
their main trade bait, but I can't see
anything. He's their Draymond Green.
He's a guy that can be 0 for 10, but he still
makes
winning plays.
Yes. Yeah. Absolutely.
And he inspires our producers here at The Jump because it's time to run it back.
Yeah.
Here are the top cross-court bounce passes of all time. Producer Bomber, let's see what you got. Number three.
Oh, man.
Jason Williams, Topeja, 2001. You knew he was going to be involved.
So many tricks up his sleeve. Look at
Watch this.
Ah. Listen.
The bullet.
When he first came in the league, I did not want to switch on him. I'm telling you right now.
Woo, number two, Russ to Oladipo in 2017. A short pairing.
That actually went between his legs, though, huh?
Wait, close up, please.
That went between his legs.
Wow. Yep. That's nice.
There you go. And then number one.
Of course.
I'm so pleased.
Of course.
It is our greatest living American, Allen Iverson, to rip Hamilton in 2009.
Grant Hill, right through his legs, too.
Look at him.
Right, because Grant Hill, his soccer skills ain't what he thought they are.
Right?
Come on, G, you can't be letting them nutmeg like that.
Nice.
That was a Hall of Famer through a Hall of Fame. Anyway.
Where's Magic?
This year's Pistons, we can do a whole list off camera. This year's Pistons not have had that many highlights like that to be proud of. Last night, Detroit fell to the Pelicans at home, and Andre Drummond was benched for the fourth quarter and overtime. Only played 22 minutes. Pistons coach Dwayne Casey said of Drummond's benching, quote, "In a situation like that, we are looking for 5 or 6 men who are playing hard and who can finish the game for us." It wasn't a message for Andre as much as it was a message for everyone who wasn't on the floor. The young guys were playing hard and earned the right to be out there. It wasn't a message for Andre. Of course it wasn't a message for Andre, guys.
He just sat down in overtime.
So.
It meant it wasn't just for Andre.
Mm-hmm.
It was for everybody who wasn't in the game.
We would
send a message through Andre.
There you go. We all know, obviously, Andre Drummond on the trading block.
Yes.
The Pistons looking to start their rebuilding process.
Yes.
Well, what happened last night hurt his trade stock at all?
No, I don't think so. I think, first of all, Andre Drummond doesn't have a history of being a really bad locker room guy. So it's not like, oh, here it is again. Yeah. He's acting up. And then as far as what he brings to the table, whether you have criticisms of it or you're just in love with the things he does, it's a known quantity. I don't think anyone out there is like, well, I didn't know Andre Drummond was that kind of player. So I don't think it hurts his trade value whatsoever. This is just Dwayne Casey trying to coach his team real time. And sometimes you have to put the incentives for the guys to know this is the level of standard that we are expecting.
No, it ain't gonna hurt. I mean, this guy's averaging 17 and 16. Are you kidding me? Anybody out there would take this guy. I mean, he's just frustrated.
Yeah.
Right? You can see it in his play. You can see it in his energy. He's frustrated. I mean, here we are in another season where they're at the bottom of the Eastern Conference. Blake Griffin is out, their best player, and it's leaving
other... He ripped his whole jersey off here. Look at this.
Other guys have to step
that
up and
easy,
do more.
And it's,
you know, it's just a level of frustration that's settling in with him, and he's got to find some way to just, you know, get through this and just continue to play hard. He's not a young buck no more.
No.
And, you know, he's a veteran player. He only been to the playoff twice, and I'm sure he wants to get back to that level, but off to a slow start.
I do expect him to be moved before the deadline. There's other guys who clearly want out. We've been talking a lot about Kevin Love clearly wanting out. I don't know if they're going to find a trade partner considering what the Cavaliers want and where Kevin might be wanted. For Andre Drummond, I think that there's going to be some combination of
yeah, no, I mean, he's got a player option next year, but everyone expects him to opt out and become a free agent. And he doesn't have an injury history like Kevin Love. He doesn't have 3 or 4 more years on his contract like Kevin Love. So it makes him a lot easier movable. It just depends on where Detroit feels like they can get the best return.
Right. Yeah.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For highlights and analysis, check out the ESPN app. And for live streaming and premium content, check out ESPN Plus.